Nothing gets between me and my AK.
Let's get to it.
Okay, YouTube, what's going on? It's Mesafail back at it with some Division. So welcome to one of my first of hopefully many, weapon reviews within the Division. And what's prompting this one is I just got a lot of comments on stream tonight. And guys, once again, thanks for all the support on my Division streams. While there's not much to do in Destiny right now except for Crucible, you guys have been very supportive and much appreciated on the Mesa front. But I did get so many comments as to, Mesa, what are you using for that primary? It just melts things. And it doesn't seem to move. And I'm saying, well, that's my beloved AK-74, the black market one. And even my teammate over here, Rockstar Ninja, there's been times where he was like, dude, what are you using? Because I would just melt some guys in front of him just like they were nothing. And it's a combination of, one, obviously my DPS, but the roll that I got on my beloved, black market AK-74. So we're going to go through what makes it so good, what talents are on it, what talents are on it, and then what attachments I'm using, because I am all about crafting. I'm going to do a separate video on crafting and how to do it efficiently, what to look for, what to use your Phoenix credits on, and it's all about blueprints, you know. Big thing in this game is everyone's looking for those high-end drops, but I gotta be frank, guys, the high-end drops I've gotten so far haven't been that great or been weapons or pieces of armor that have been that useful to me. But blueprints, it's a whole other deal because you can roll, you're gonna craft as many of that item until you get what you want. Before someone chimes in, I'll do in before recalibration. Recalibration, I'll do another video on that. It's too risky. And I say too risky because it costs a lot of money. And especially when you're re-rolling things that are high-end, a la yellow, exotic, I'm still calling them exotic from Destiny, the more you recalibrate it, the more expensive it gets. But with blueprints, it just costs high-end parts, okay? You just keep recrafting them until you get the god roll. My boy Expat, his black market AK-74, he made 9 of them until he got the one that he wanted. It only took me, I think, 4 or 5 of them. So, but we're going to get into it, and I'll show you how to craft it, where to get the blueprints and everything. So the first thing you're going to need is Phoenix credits. Well, where do you get Phoenix credits from? You get them from killing bosses in the Dark Zone. You get them from killing bosses just anywhere, okay, in the PvE non-Dark Zone places. But you also get them from the dailies, okay? In the dailies, you have 3 of them every day. You've got challenging, then you've got hard, and you've got hard, okay? Challenging, you want to do that one first, and you want to do that when you feel comfortable, okay? At first, the challenging one was very challenging for me. I was having a tough time with them. We were completing them, but it would take us a long time. But now that me and my crew, I mean, we're all really high DPS, decent health. My DPS is about over 120,000. My health is about 60. My skill power is only about 10 or 15, which sucks, but whatever. I'd rather have DPS and health right now. We're pretty much going through the challenge mode, the challenging daily, pretty easily. And then once you do the challenging, hard modes, they're just a breeze. You just blow through them. So what you want to do is you want to go to the special gear vendor, okay? He's on the second floor in the tech wing right next to the recalibration station, okay? Now, the special gear vendor is going to sell regular weapons and also some armor pieces that you could just buy, okay? I wouldn't say don't buy them. If you see something you like that's going to help you with what you're looking to build in terms of stats and weapons, go ahead. But down at the bottom, when you scroll all the way down, he's selling blueprints, okay? And all of this costs Phoenix credits, okay? So at this particular time when I bought my AK, I had 274 credits, okay? This one cost me 180. But then I've got the blueprint, and as long as I've got the materials, I can build them over and over. I buy it once, I build it over and over. Then to actually build it from the crafting station, you're going to need high-end materials, okay? You're going to need 5 high-end weapon parts and then 3 high-end tools, okay? Well, how do you get those? Well, in the crafting station, you can turn everything into what you want, okay? So you can turn, green materials into blue materials into then high-end materials, okay? So collect everything, okay? If you see something green on the ground, just pick it up, okay? Dismantle it. If you see something blue and you don't need it, don't matter. Pick it up and break it down because you'll eventually need these materials if you want to make as many weapons as you can till you get that god roll. So this is me here just taking a bunch of blues and turning them into high ends, okay? I'm just getting a whole bunch because I also bought some other blueprints for knee pads and backpacks and all sort of stuff that are high end, and I'm going to need parts for them, so I'm trying to get as many high end materials as possible. So again, collect everything. So here I am crafting. You can see on the top left right there, three question marks. Those are the three random talents you can get every time you craft one, okay? So don't worry about getting something and then recalibrating it, okay? Now, what I'm looking for is, first off, I'm looking at the damage, and I'm just comparing it to another weapon of the similar ilk, okay? So here I am comparing it just to my, tactical MK16, right? Is it 16? 16, which only has 5,800, okay? This one has more damage, I see right off the bat. But I'm looking at the perks here, and nothing I really like here, okay? Another thing you gotta keep in mind is when you do get something that you like with all three talents that you like, okay? Gotta make sure that your firearms, your electronics, and your stamina all allow you to have those perks unlocked. Like for me, with my setup right now, my AK has all the talents unlocked, but if I try to use my Vector, even though it's got great perks and talents, why do I keep calling them perks? It has great talents, they're all locked. I can't use it. So my Vector's not good, but my AK is perfect. So the three talents that you want to roll for, or at least I would recommend, is balanced, deadly, and capable. Or at least that's what's on mine. That's what I love, okay? Balance really helps with the recoil because you reach max accuracy when the weapon is shouldered. That just means aim down sight. I clarified that with Arix Gaming, actually. Now, the deadly talent, is going to give me a whopping 26% more critical damage, and then we top it off with capable, where if I use a skill, it's actually going to improve the handling for 13 seconds. So with all of that, especially balanced, okay, combining it with some attachments, which I'm going to show you right now, it just, the recoil is just non-existent on this thing, or at least for me it isn't, okay? I usually used to have to burst fire this my AKs, not this one, okay? Next up, I crafted myself a scope, a magazine, an underbarrel, and also a muzzle. And all of your attachments add to the DPS, okay? When I had all superior attachments, this thing was maybe topping out at 105 DPS, okay? But because of these attachments, even the magazine bumps up the DPS. That's why you gotta really pick and choose. And I'll do a whole video on crafting 101 and what I went through to get all these attachments. I recorded all of it, okay? But let's start off with the magazine. So first off, I get an 84.5% increase in magazine size. And I get a 26.1% rate of fire increase, but that's what really bumped up the DPS, okay? Before I put all these high-end attachments on it, the DPS on this thing was maybe topping out at like 105, 110 or something like that. But with that magazine specifically, it bumped it up like at least maybe, I'd say 8,000 DPS. And I probably should have mentioned this, all of these attachments I bought blueprints for. I didn't actually buy the attachments, bought the blueprints, and then I could craft them over and over for different weapons too, because I'm using them on my, Caduceus, which I don't really like actually, because I got a bad roll in it. I use it on my Vector, I use it on a new police MK17 scout rifle that I got. But guys, it's so much customization. So there's a CQBSS scope that he has the blueprint for this week, and also a large muzzle. So on my scope, I get 21% headshot damage, I get plus 6.5 critical hit chance. On my muzzle, I get another 31.5% stability, and also 6.5 critical hit chance. Then the underbarrel that I bought gives me another 31% stability. So, guys, I know that's a lot of numbers, but get the numbers. Bottom line is, you buy the blueprint of the weapon, you craft it until you get the rolls that you want, talent that you want, then you do the same thing with the attachments, okay? Unless you see an attachment that has exactly what you want in it, don't buy it, okay? Get a blueprint of it from that special gear vendor and just craft till you get what you want. Now, at the time of this video going live, I checked in with the special gear vendor, and he's not selling this blueprint right now. Does that mean he's never going to sell it? No, his stock refreshes once a week, okay? So you can go back and get this AK. And if he does bring it back, when he does come back with this blueprint, buy the blueprint for the black market AK-74. You won't regret it. So that's pretty much it for the video, guys. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think. I know this is kind of a weird review video because you can't just go buy this thing, okay? It's not like the Liberator. And let me know in the comment section, are there other weapons you want to see me review? Okay, I still haven't gotten the Midas yet. Do you want me to go buy the Liberator? I'll go buy it just to review it for you guys if you guys are interested in it, okay? But the bottom line for this video is I love my AK. If, for me, it's the best gun in the game right now. I tried the Caduceus. I've tried so many other different assault rifles. The AK, when you get the stability down, it just hits like a Mack truck, okay? It has so many rounds in the magazine. And then once you start crafting other high-end attachments to it, the thing is just a monster. So that is it, guys. Let me know in the comment section what other weapons you want to see me review and what other division types of vids you want me to make, okay? So that's it. And guys, don't worry about Destiny. There's always going to be tons of Destiny on the channel. I'm just slipping in division in between because I love this freaking game, okay? Anyway, Babble Mode's engaged. Drop a like in this video only if you see fit. Follow me on Twitter. At Mace Chun, check out my stream. Links in the description. That's it. I'm out of here like Vladimir.